You ask what I would like people to know about my figures, my sentinels, and why I made them. But in reality, I'd rather the viewer didn't know anything about these works in advance. I'd rather they came into the space of them unprepared, as if stumbling across some private ritual, a meeting place or sacred site. And I'm not sure who they are. Sometimes I feel I'm just a conduit for them to be brought into some material existence at this point. I had a strong sense of purpose in bringing these beings into the world. For me, they are guardians, powerful energies that hold the world in focus, while we are living in chaos and uncertainty. I have to put on the head or the face before I can do anything. I call them out. I call them out. The head appears, and I build and I cut and I carve until the being reveals itself. It's not immediate. Sometimes I redo the face many times until there is a recognition, a sort of aha, there you are. It is as though through the process I've been waiting for whoever it is to come through. After that, I might look and recognize features that could be African, Chinese, Native American, Gothic, etc. But I don't set out to make them. It is a co-creation. Making these works is a journey. It's very physical. Clay's heavy, and I'm up and down ladders. I build, carve, model, then carve again. These new sentinels harken back to the recent sculptures I made of figures emerging from, or merging back into rock. Clay knows how to become rock, and of course clay comes from the weathering of rock. And then there is bronze. I have often spoken about the personal alchemical transmutation that I feel happens for me through the act of making my work, that sometimes I feel altered by the process itself. I also like the idea that in the transfer from the original clays to the bronze casts, a mirroring happens in the making of the molds. A similar reversal happens in my printmaking. I'm not sure that I can explain why that excites me, but it does. It is as if there needs to be a type of symmetry, a kind of mirror matter, before the work reaches its final state. When the molds were being removed from the clay originals, many of the heads fell off and were fractured. They lay around in my studio for a while, and then one day I really looked at them and found great beauty in their fragmentation. I thought about the aesthetic of fragments and why we love the fragmented and the broken. We like to be aware of that sense of time, of history, and those who came before us. You asked me if I planned to make the paintings based on my sculptures. My answer is that I don't really plan to do anything. For me, the creative process is just to start, to do something, anything, and then to respond, to be alert to all the possibilities. There's something about the heavy solidity and physical effort required in making the sculptures, and then the quick re-seeing of them on paper, only using water, charcoal dust, Indian ink, and very diluted acrylic, with perhaps a minimal use of pastel. And that gives them a different life. The sculptures are heavy, taking up space in the world, whereas the paintings are transient, fleeting, like memories. When I made the sentinels, I did feel a calling of sorts to bring forth these beings that could stand guard and hold the material world in focus in the midst of chaos. And now, looking back a year later, I can find meaning for myself in the idea that I was tasked with doing this precisely for the time we are now in. When I see the completed sculptures in an exhibition space, they stand as something quite separate from me. I'm not sure if I gave birth to them, or if I was just the midwife.